After our body detects a homeostatic imbalance, it responds through one of the two feedback mechanisms, either by a negative feedback or a positive feedback. In this video, we will talk about the negative feedback mechanism, and we will use some examples to explain it. The most common type of feedback mechanism in our body is the negative feedback. And even though its name might give us some negative vibes, this type of feedback mechanism is crucial and has positive effects when dealing with homeostatic imbalances. Okay, so now I'm sounding like I'm promoting or defending this feedback mechanism, so let's just jump into its definition. To cut it short, the negative feedback is an opposite response to the stimulus. It works in a way to shut off the original stimulus. In other words, it tries to reduce its intensity. To make it easier for you to understand, you can consider it as a household thermostat. When the temperature increases, the thermostat shuts off, and vice versa. In this case, the increase of temperature would represent the stimulus, and the thermostat shutting off would be the negative feedback. We have so many conditions that are regulated by this type of mechanism, such as the body temperature, the blood pressure, the hormonal level. I will use the regulation of blood pressure by negative feedback as an example to show you how this mechanism works. I am sure that if you haven't understood it yet, you will after this example. So please keep watching. First, an internal or external stimulus will cause the increase of the blood pressure. This change is going to be detected by the baroreceptors, which are pressure-sensitive receptors. These receptors will send an input via afferent pathways to a control system. They will send nerve impulses to the brain in order to interpret them. After the interpretation, the brain will send the response via nerve impulses to the effectors, which are the heart and the blood vessels. The heart rate will decrease, causing a decrease in the blood pressure. The blood pressure will continue decreasing until it reaches its normal level. Hence, the homeostasis is achieved. Now, as we noticed, the response to the increase of the blood pressure, which is the stimulus, is a decrease in the blood pressure. Therefore, this response kept reducing the intensity of the stimulus until the blood pressure was back to its normal level. This was everything you should know about the negative feedback mechanism. I will do another video explaining the positive feedback mechanism. I hope you enjoyed this video and thank you so much for watching. Bye!